Welcome back to the mini river ecosystem. In the last video, I created a thriving little river habitat and added some river creatures including snails, cherry shrimp, and one of the smallest fish in the world, the Pandaka Pygmaea, aka the Philippine Dwarf Goby. And today, things are about to get even more exciting. We're adding new water creatures, and watch how the small river community comes to life. The residents of our mini river ecosystem are settling in just fine. And it's finally time to introduce this cobalt blue goby to the ecosystem. But after adding them to the tank, they vanished. They are nowhere to be found. Over on the land area, some of the plants have started growing new leaves, which is always a great sign. And honestly, it makes me really happy. This small ecosystem is alive. In the water area, I made a few changes. I added more aqua soil, introduced some new plants, and tweaked the layout a bit to create more space. I was watching the tank when I noticed something interesting. Look at this one. One of the gobies was actually digging a hole under a rock and carrying something in its tiny mouth. Is that an aqua soil? While the gobies are still shy, I started to notice some problems. Mold was beginning to grow on the plants, which is a bad thing. It could affect their health and growth. And honestly, it was making everything look kind of ugly. Even some of the snails had mold growing on their shells. Oh no! To reduce molds, I thought I needed a really good algae eater. While some of the current tank residents eat algae, they just weren't keeping up with it. I needed reinforcements. So I decided to add mollies. Meet these two new additions. They don't have names yet, so if you have any suggestions, drop them in the comments. Right after I introduce them to the tank, they get straight to work. Look at those busy little mouths. And after just a few days, the molds had noticeably reduced and the tank looked so much cleaner. I also noticed that the blue cobalt gobies have been coming out more lately. They seem more comfortable now and are looking even more vibrant. Their skin has this beautiful iridescence, shifting colors depending on how the light hits them. Thank you. I noticed one of my blue shrimp is undergoing a process called molting. Shrimp usually molt because they need to grow or repair and regenerate body parts. Their exoskeleton doesn't stretch, so they periodically shed it. So this is its brand new self. It must have felt so much lighter now after shedding its old exoskeleton. This mini river ecosystem seems to have balanced out well. The neon gobies are doing just fine. The shrimps have become more vibrant. And the Pandaka Pygmaea fish are just as calm as always. But the snails, they're kind of getting out of control. Eggs and babies are everywhere. They breed so much quicker than I thought. Please watch out on our next videos on how we can control their population. For now, I am enjoying how the other inhabitants are doing in the tank. And if you like this video, please like and consider subscribing.